Good afternoon, students. Myself Vaishali Jadhav, working as associate professor in Information Technology Department of Saraswati College of Engineering. My area of interest is computer network, and today we are going to discuss some basic terms related to computer networks. Now we'll start with the computer network definition. What is computer network? If one or more machines connected with each other for sharing of information, sharing of resources, it is known as computer networks. In order to establish a network, we need hardware parts as well as software parts. Now today we are going to focus about the software part of computer network. In order to do communication over a network, we need a very basic entity, that is operating system, and that operating system is network operating system. The system basically consists of networking models which allow communication, it means which allow transmission of data from one location to another location. So one of the reference model which is used for communication system today we have to discuss in this lecture, and that is OSI reference model, open source interconnection reference model. Now in OSI reference model there are 7 layers, starting from physical to application. Layer 1 physical, layer 2 data link, layer 3 network, layer 4 transport, layer 5 session, layer 6 presentation, and layer 7 application layer. So these are 7 layers. So basically what happens in communication, there is one sender operating on one machine, let us say it is a sender operating on machine A, and there is a receiver operating on another machine, let us say that machine is B. Now basically what happens, user is operating on machine A, when it create a message, the message will has to pass from machine A to machine B. So how actually the message get passed? User using one of the application program write or create a message, then that message has to deliver layer by layer from up to bottom at sender side. Then physically this data has to be transmitted from one location to another location by using physical medium. Then this physical medium may be wired or wireless. So when data ultimately reaches at destination at receiver's place, the data move from physical to application layer, that is bottom to up, and then through application layer receiver which is available at machine B able to receive that information. So this is the flow from sender to receiver. At sender side data has to flow from top to bottom, that is application to physical, and at receiver side data flow from physical to application. Now we have to discuss about functionalities provided by each and every layer. Now before starting functionalities in detail, there are some basic terms we must know. Now communication models. The task of communication model is very complex, very huge, and in order to sort out that, the complex task is divided into small tasks, and every small task is assigned to layers. In order to do further simplification, these layers are arranged in a hierarchical fashion. These layers are arranged in a stack where they made compulsion, the layer which is below has to provide certain services to the layer which is above it. It means physical layer should provide certain services to the data link layer. So services part comes in the picture. Fine, physical layer will provide certain services to the data link layer, but what kind of services? That is defined by the interface, that is nothing but the connectivity between these two layers. So this is the interface which define what kind of services physical layer provide to the data link, and so on. So interface terms comes in the picture. Now two parties are communicating with each other, for successful communication definitely both the parties has to follow certain rules, regulations. So, rules are nothing but protocols, and protocols are applicable for the entities which belongs from every layer for further communication with receiver entity. So, term protocol comes here. So, basically communication model consists of various layers connected by interfaces, and they are following certain rules in terms of protocols, and this we called it as network architecture. So, basically network architecture is combination of layers connected by interfaces followed certain protocols for communication. Now, moving back again to the layers responsibility, the bottommost layer is physical layer. Now, basically this layer is only connected, physically it is connected to transmission medium, and that is why the responsibility of this layer is transmission of data in terms of bits from one location to next, from one hop to the next hop. While performing certain responsibilities, physical layer handles some other task also. Now, the very first task is physical layer define electromechanical specification of interface which connect physical layer to the physical medium. Now, physical layer handle data in terms of bits. But actually when data is traveling from one to another, it is moving through physical medium, and that physical medium may be wired or wireless. If it is wired, then it may be twisted coaxial fiber optics, and through wire what kind of, and through wire in what form data is transmitted? In electromagnetic waves. If it is wireless, then radio waves. So, whatever digitalized data available at physical layer need to convert into electromagnetic or optical cable or radio waves. So, who is taking the responsibility of conversion of digital data into analog, for example? That is physical layer, and that process we called it as encoding. So, at sender side encoding is done by physical layer, data will travel through physical medium from one hop to next hop. When it reaches to the next hop physical layer, now it responsibility of next hop physical layer to decode that signals. It means convert analog signal into digital signal. So, we conclude that encoding and decoding is another responsibility of physical layer. Next is physical layer also play part for defining transmission rate, that is how many bits transmitted per second. So, this is about physical layer. The very first transmission of data in terms of bit, it define electromechanical specification of interface, second task, third task it do encoding as well as decoding, and fourth task is it also helps to define data transmission rate. Now, moving ahead, above physical layer data link layer comes. Now, data link layer, see at sender side data is moving, actual user message is moving from application to physical, from top to bottom. Who is above data link layer? Network layer. So, network layer will provide message to data link layer for transmission. Whatever message size network layer are able to handles, data link layer are not able to handle. So, what data link layer do? Whatever message received from network layer converted into manageable unit, and that unit we called it as frame. So, the very first task of data link layer is transmission of data in terms of frame from one hop to the next hop. For certain transmission of frames, some other task also data link layer handle, and these are error control, flow control, physical addressing and transmission of data over a shared medium handling. So, basically this data link layer is divided into two sub layers. The first one is logical link control and second one is MAC, that is medium access control sub layer. What are the responsibilities of data link layer? That is framing, error control, flow control, physical address and shared medium control. Now, among these five, first four responsibilities are handled by logical link control and some part of framing as well as shared medium control is done by MAC layer. Now, above that network layer comes. Now, network layer handles data in terms of packets. When there is a need of network layer, when there is a delivery of data across the network, when there is a delivery of data from one network to another network, network layer comes in the picture. So, basically primary responsibility of network layer, transmission of data in terms of packet from all the way of source location to final destination location, not as like that of physical and data link. Physical and data link layer only transmit data from one to next hop, then no matter whether the next hop is intermediate device or final destination. But here network layer has to take responsibility transmission of data not only from transmission of data from source location to destination location. So, in order to fulfill this responsibility, some other task also handled by network layer, and that is assigning IP addresses and routing. Now, in order to deliver data to a correct receiver, the receiver should able to identify uniquely, unique ID receiver must have, whether the machine is on same network or other network. If machine on the same network, physical address is sufficient. But if there is a talk across the network, globally uniquely identification of machine need some other kind of identity, and that identity is provided in terms of IP, that is internet protocol address. So, assigning and maintaining IP addresses is also one of the responsibility of network layer, only for unique identification of machine globally, so that data get delivered when the machine is acting as a receiver. And second is routing. So, when data move across the network, there are multiple intermediate devices. These intermediate devices are multiple paths to transmit the data, to forward the data, to push the data towards the receiver. Among available multiple paths, which one has to be chosen to avoid the congestion, to avoid delay and ensure quality? That decision is nothing but the routing decision, and that is normally done by intermediate devices, for example, router. Now, above network layer, there is transport layer. Now, transport layer handle data either in terms of datagram or segment. Now, what is the responsibility of transport layer? Now, if we think about today's machine, now today's machines are multi-power, multi-processing units. It means multiple processes are simultaneously executing on a single machine. Now, for example, when we communicate, nowadays we are using WhatsApp, Facebook for communication purpose. Now, when you forward message through WhatsApp to your friend will receive that message through WhatsApp only. When you forward a message through SMS, your friend will receive the message through SMS only. What does it mean? Sender ka WhatsApp is actually communicating with WhatsApp at the receiver. Sender ka SMS is actually communicating with receiver SMS. It means what we need process to process delivery. In communication, process to process delivery is very important. And As today's computer are very powerful, multiple processes are executing on same machine. And that's why every process should need to be uniquely identified. For unique identification of every process, process ID is assigned by your operating system. These are soft ports, that is port addresses. Process IDs are nothing but port addresses, and port addresses are assigned to every process for its unique identification purpose. So, the responsibility of transport layer, transmission of data from one process of sender machine to its corresponding process at receiver machine. What network layer do? Transmit data from sender location to receiver location. At receiver machine, multiple processes are executing. The data jab sender transmit karega, to whom data should be forwarded? Corresponding process. It means if WhatsApp is executing on this desktop, corresponding WhatsApp process at receiver should receive that message. Okay? So, process to process delivery is handled by transport layer. So, to handle this responsibility properly, transport layer performs certain operation. The very first operation of transport layer is assignment of port addresses to the process. Port addresses are nothing but process IDs, which are assigned automatically by your operating system. So, shall we conclude your transport layer is part of operating system? Yes. The transport layer, it is a completely software layer and it is a part of operating system. Now, second functionality is transport layer perform segmentation and assembly. So, what is segmentation? About transport layer, session layer comes. Session layer at sender side, session layer will handle data to the transport layer. Now, whatever data session layer handle, transport layer convert into manageable units, and that units we called it as segment. For unique identification, every segment is numbered. Now, ultimately the data in terms of multiple segments will be forwarded from source to destination. At destination side, segments may reach out of order. Segment may reach out of order sequence. So, to make all the segments in order, to arrange all the segments in order, another functionality receiver transport layer has to perform, that is reassembly. So, segmentation and reassembly is another responsibility of transport layer. Now, third responsibility is error control. So, what data link layer do? Data link layer control error from one hop to next hop. But here, transport layer has to control error not only from source location to destination location, from source process to its corresponding destination process at receiver. That is error control. Now, fourth responsibility of transport layer is flow control. So, again it differs from data link layer. Data link layer do flow control from one hop to next, while transport layer do flow control from source process to destination process, if in case sender process is faster than receiver, to avoid losses of segments as receiver is less capable than the sender for processing further data. So, these all are responsibilities of transport layer. So, first responsibility port address, second segmentation assembly, third responsibility error control, fourth responsibility flow control. That is about transport layer. Now, about transport layer, session layer is there, and session layer is commonly known as dialog controller. So, when two parties are talking with each other, whenever there is a talk in two parties, we called it as session. And the way session get control, that is handled by session layer. So, session layer will only monitor the sessions, the communication which is happening between two parties. For example, there is a session of 1 hour. So, if both the parties are using connection oriented services, the connection must be there between two parties for 1 hour. There are certain rules of communication also, whether the two parties are communicating in a simplex way, half duplex way or full duplex way. That is also monitored, that is also governed by the session layer. Session also introduced the concept of checkpoint. What is the meaning of checkpoint? Now, if huge amount of data, when you need to transmit from sender to receiver, at a time if you transmit 100 kbps data to the receiver, when receiver receive that data completely and verify it, after that it come to know ki certain errors are there. Then receiver will ask sender, whatever you forwarded, certain errors are there, retransmit it. Then 100 kbps data again sender need to retransmit to the receiver. Delay and wastage of resources for retransmission. To avoid this, what session layer do? Okay, huge data, 100 kbps data, so it divides into 10 kbps data, and after 10 kbps sender has to ask receiver whether you have received 10 kbps data correctly. Okay, then send next 10 kbps data. So, if in the last, for example, let us suppose if certain errors occur in one of the 10 kbps data, then only that 10 kbps data only need to be retransmit. Okay? So, that is the responsibility of session layer. Now, next is presentation layer. Now, as its name suggests, it present your system. What does it means? Presentation layer is responsible for defining syntax and semantic of language, of communication language which your machine is using. At the same time, presentation layer is perform encryption decryption task as well as comprehension task. Now, above presentation layer, application layer comes. So, basically user access networks services through application layer. So, application layer actually made to interact with the user. So, these are all the layers of OSI, ISO, OSI, reference model.